Learning how to navigate the report authoring environment can improve your Cognos Analytics experience and help make you more efficient. This video will show how to create new reports and edit existing ones, the navigation menu, page design and page preview, the on-demand toolbar, and authoring functions. There are two ways to edit an existing report. First, you could run the report by clicking on it and then toggle Edit in the viewer. Or a more direct way is select the report, click the three dots, and click Edit Report. Or, with the report selected, right mouse click and select Edit Report. The report opens in edit mode and in this example shows the design view for a page called Summary. The navigation menu enables you to quickly move between report pages, prompt pages, and queries. To move to the report pane, select report. A report description, data sources, parameters, the number of report objects, and the number of page objects is shown. A report can also be validated from this pane. To change to the pages pane, click pages. Report pages can be viewed and created here. Selecting the summary page brings it into focus. A page preview and the page properties can be seen. To add a page, double-click page in the pages view. Double-click page 1 to get focus, and select the type of report that you want to create. To add customer data, double-click the data elements that you'd like to add. And you can change from the design view to the page view. When this runs, the report is now populated with data. The Go Back button can be used to return to the last object viewed. In this case, it's back to page design. To change to the Queries pane, click Queries. In this pane, queries can be created or modified. As data is added to a report, a query is built automatically. Query 1 was created in the previous step as data was added to the customer report. Complex tasks such as creating joins and unions are also done here. To rename a query, select it, right mouse click, to see the data that would be returned by the query, select it, and select View Tabular Data, and the results will be shown. Returning to the Query page, to edit a query, you can either select it and right-click and click Edit, or you can double-click it. Additional data can be dragged onto the query, or you can double-click to add data. To remove data, select it, and press Delete. Filters can be used to restrict data by filtering out what is not necessary. To include only customers in Connecticut and Alabama, state is dropped into detail filters, and the filter expression opens. Since we're filtering for two values, the IN function will be used. I can type it myself, or I could select it from the functions list that appears. When I select state, the value icons turn on. In this case, I want to select multiple values. To test that the filter is working, I can view tabular data. Returning to the customer report I created, the on-demand toolbar contains actions that can be performed on an object, and it floats near the active object. I can pin the toolbar to keep it in the upper left corner of the canvas if I don't want it moving around. Hovering over a toolbar icon shows the action. For example, to add a background color to customer data, I select it, click background color, and pick the color I want. On the far right, the property panes shows the properties of the object selected. Reporting functions are also available during authoring. For example, save and save as, undo and redo the last change, and run, which lets you pick the format that the report will run in. This concludes the demonstration of how to navigate the IBM Cognos report authoring environment. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.